There is some good. Brace yourself. Your life will never be the same. Get ready for there is still some good. Times where people are seeing people that they would expect to spend some time with them, at least said hello, at least say how you're doing, at least try to pick you up a little bit or cheer you up a little bit, but they're going to the other side of the road. I bet you if he had any life left in him, he looked up and he saw the priest, and he said help is on the way, only to be wounded even deeper, because the priest went the other way. And I'm talking to thousands and thousands and thousands of people that you look for the priest and you look for the Levite, the priest of the house, the minister of the house. You look for the fivefold, the apostle, the pastor. Oh my God. You look for the evangelist and the teacher. You look for the pastor in this hour of shaking. But it seems like everybody you look for to step in and knock on the door, or at least call you, or at least send your text, or at least in your email, seem like they're all went to the other side. But I want you to know that God will never go to the other side. And some people, you've got to understand that who you least expect is going to come by and see about you. Somebody need to know that God will never fail. That the vessel that you think he's going to use won't even show up. And the least likely candidate, oh, I can see it right now. Drug addicts, people that have been addicted to drugs, gonna come out of that thing and begin to show works of kindness. People that used to be called the alcoholic, you know, Ned the Wino, he gonna sober up during this time and show works of kindness. People that you thought was the prodigal son and the prodigal daughter is gonna come up out of the grave, throw off those grave clothes, and begin to say, Mama, I'm home. What do you need? Daddy, what do you need? Sisters and brothers, what do you need? I need to hear God right now. There are some people that people say that backslid. You know, left the church because they were wounded or deceived or whatever. God is going to awaken their spirit this very hour, and they're going to be the ones that's going to pick you up along the way. They're going to be the ones that say, you know, one day God spoke to me in a dream, and I saw you down and out, and going to take this money and pay your bills. Oh, somebody's going to get $500 from the least likely candidate, because God is on the move. So let's go back to the scriptures. Verse 33, are you still with me? But a Samaritan, but the least likely candidate, first the one everybody gave up on. Oh my Lord, I want some energy and some life and the power of God to hit somebody right now that's listening to this broadcast. And I want you to know that God is with you. I want you to know that God is on your side. I want you to know that God is still using you in these last days. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Why don't you say, God is still with me? And I want somebody who's the least likely candidate, somebody that you can feel the stirring in your soul right now. Somebody that everybody's giving up on, and you just happen to tune in at this time because God wants you to hear this. He's going to ignite your soul. He's going to bless you financially, and you're going to go back to somebody that's been stripped, because you know what it's like to be stripped. You're going to go back to somebody that's been beat up, because you know what it's like to be beat up. You're going to go back to somebody that's half dead, because you know what it's like to be half dead. You're going to go back to somebody who had everybody who they thought would be there, turn their backs on them, and you're going to go there, and you're going to minister to their needs, because you know what it feels like with everybody turn their back on you. We're talking about the Samaritan, the hated one, the despised one, the least likely one. But a Samaritan who was traveling that way came upon the man, and when he saw him, his heart was filled with pity. Oh my Lord Jesus, I want some people out there that know what it's like to be beat up, to be down, to be out, to be forsaken. God is raising you up. God is bringing you out of the grave clothes. And he's going to use you mightily in this hour because you can have pity. You have compassion. You know about the hurting. You know about being forsaken. You know what it's like to be thrown up under the bus, the truck, and everything else. You know what it's like not to have friends. You know what it's like to be looked at and scorned and criticized. You know what it's like to be diseased and don't nobody want to be around you when you're diseased. But God is sending a word of healing and deliverance. Even those that are quarantined in this hour, maybe you're going through some diseases right now that people say, I will come by, but I will, you know how that is. But God is saying, be healed in the name of Jesus. Get up off that bed of affliction and know that God is on your side. So the Samaritan went by there and he went over to the him. Who is him? The one that had been stripped, the one that had been beat, the one that had been left half dead. He went over to that one. He went over, he poured in the oil and the wine. What is the oil and the wine? What is the oil and the wine, Dr. Dixon? The oil and the wine is the healing power of God. He poured in healing properties. Have you ever been around an anointed person? A person that just have fresh oil on them. A person that you know they have the presence of God upon them. And whenever they call you on the phone, you can feel God on the phone. Whenever you're in their presence, you just feel lifted up. Somebody need to get some fresh oil about them. Somebody need to get a hold of some fresh oil. That when people are in your presence, my God, they feel the very presence of God. Somebody say, raise the standards. Raise the standards. Raise the standards that your very presence will bring healing and deliverance to people. Talking to me all day would be okay. Dialoguing all day would be okay. My God, telling me how unjust some things are okay. But if you really want me to be moved, get the presence of God in your life and be able to say a due word in the due season. Be able to just say, I'll come by there for a second, and you just stay for a second, and you're doing your social distancing, but that person still feel the power of God. Somebody say, raise the standards. And so he went over, he poured in the oil and the wine on his wounds, and he bandaged them. My God. Oh, have you ever been there when you had wounds and things, open sores, but somebody had enough love and compassion to bandage them? Thank God for our health professionals who still have pity. Thank God for those that are in law enforcement and those that are protecting and those that are doing things who still have pity. My God, my God. Thank God for the good neighbor. Huh? Look at somebody say, there is still some good. Then he put the man on his own animal and took him to an inn where he took care of him. Oh, can you see the transition? Can you see what happened? Can you see that God would never forsake you? When you're down at your lowest, God is going to send somebody. It may be the least likely candidate. That's what I hear now. I'm hearing for some people right now. Don't turn your nose up to who comes your way. Don't put nothing on it. Don't put, say, well, God used this one or God won't use that one. And God, oh my Lord, let's go there for a half a second. Some people out there that's listening to me, you gave up on your prodigal son and your prodigal daughter, and they are trying to reach out to you, but you shut down on them. You say, I don't even want them in the house. You say, I don't want that money. No telling where it came from. He out there maybe selling drugs or whatever. But God is saying, open your heart, that whoever he sends your way, know that he has sent that person your way. And no, Dr. Dixon is not telling you to take drug money. And no, Dr. Dixon is not telling you to condone illegal activities. But what I am saying is, don't be so religious that you put a label on goodness. God will use anybody to be good to you, because there is what? Still some good. The next day he took out some silver coins, 2 silver coins, and gave them to the innkeeper to take care of him. And when you read it in the other translation and you do the math, it was a whole day's wage that he got for working all day long. He gave it to that man. Oh, will somebody say, I'm talking to those that are working in industries. You don't make a whole lot of money, but you got a big heart. Why don't you put your hands in the air and say, God, fill me up, because you know that if I would, I would give my last. There is still some good. And he said, when I come back this way, I will pay you whatever else to spend on him. Can you imagine the least likely candidate, the least likely one, the Samaritan, is saying, I'm going to be a good neighbor. I don't know this man. We don't believe the same. We don't have the same bloodline. Our ideological is different, but I still want to do good. You see, if you read the scriptures and if you read these scriptures, God is not the author of confusion. God is not one that brings division and strife between mankind. My God, you don't have to be the same color. You don't have to have the same religious views. You don't have to have the same social views, but you can be a good neighbor. You can show the love of God. You see, it's something about love that transcends everything. Love has no color. Love has no barriers. I need somebody to go to 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter. I'll say that slow. I need somebody to take some time after this broadcast and just go to 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter, and educate yourself concerning love. Because sometimes what we call love can't be tested in the middle of chaos. My God, what we call love, it doesn't last in the middle of social illnesses and diseases and all this stuff. See, that kind of love is not the Bible love. My God, the Bible says we are to walk in love.